Let's see the characteristics of catalysts. First one, you know, a catalyst does not initiate a reaction, but it changes the rate of reaction. A catalyst does not initiate a reaction, but alters the reaction. That means a catalyst does not start the reaction. When reaction is going on, then reaction affects how, whether it is a positive catalyst increases the rate, whether it is a negative catalyst decreases the rate. Generally, catalyst, the word is used for positive catalyst. If it is negative catalyst, we must use the word negative. So catalyst means generally positive catalyst. So a catalyst does not initiate a reaction but alters the reaction. Second one, a catalyst remains unchanged chemically at the end of the reaction. A catalyst remains unchanged chemically at the end of the reaction. What is its meaning? A catalyst, generally catalyst, most of the catalysts, they involve in the they do not involve in the reaction. But in some reaction, what happens is catalyst also participate in the reaction. If any substance participate in the reaction, it is called reactant. But if it participates in the reaction initially, but finally it should be regenerated. So it remains unchanged chemically. Its formula won't change. If temporarily it involved in the reaction, at the end of the reaction it must be generated. Then only it is said to be catalyst. So that is the second point. Third one. A catalyst works effectively in smaller amounts and in finely divided state. So it works effectively. A catalyst works effectively in finely divided state. Finely divided state and in smaller amounts. Why finely divided state only effective? Why not the coarserly particles? Because finely divided state has more surface area. In the adsorption I had explained, which has more surface area? A solid lump or a finely divided solid, which will have more surface area? Yes, a finely divided solid has more surface area. That's why a catalyst must be added as powder, not as solid lumps. Moreover, small amounts it must be added, not in larger amounts. So a catalyst works effectively when it is added finely divided state and in small amounts. See the next one. What is its effect in a reversible reaction? Reversible reaction means a reaction which occurs in both forward and backward reaction. Forward and backward. That means conversion of reactant into products, conversion of products into reactants. If both are present, now that is called reversible reaction. You know, in a reversible reaction, there is a stage, equilibrium stage, where rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. At equilibrium, rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward. What is the effect of catalyst when added to a reversible reaction? There, catalyst does not affect the position of equilibrium. It does not affect the position of equilibrium. Affecting equilibrium position means disturbing the rates, rate of forward and backward. It does not disturb the rate. but it speeds up. If it is positive catalyst na, it speeds up the attainment of equilibrium. So a catalyst does not affect, a catalyst does not affect the position of equilibrium. EQLM means equilibrium, but it speeds up the attainment of equilibrium. Attainment of equilibrium, that is the effect of a catalyst in the reversible reaction. Next point, you know, a catalyst works effectively at a certain optimum conditions, optimum temperature, pressure and pH. It works effectively at a optimum, for each catalyst there will be some optimum temperature, pressure, pH, etc. To be effective, a catalyst, for each catalyst there must be some temperature, some pressure, some pH. Okay, next one, what is the effect of temperature on the catalyst? You know, working of a catalyst may increase or decrease with increase in temperature. For metals and metal oxides, increase in temperature increases the activity of catalyst. Increase in temperature increases the activity of catalyst. But for enzymes, you know, enzymes are also catalysts. Enzymes are called biocatalysts because they catalyze biological reactions. For such biocatalysts, with increase in temperature, their activity decreases. So what is the effect of temperature on catalyst? Activity of metal or metal oxide catalyst. Metal or metal oxide catalyst increases with the increase in temperature, but that of enzymes decreases with the increase in temperature. So metals and metal oxides have one type of activity by increasing temperature, and enzymes have another activity. Activity of enzymes decreases with increasing temperature, whereas the activity of metals and metal oxides increases with increasing temperature. See the next point. Next one, a catalyst action is selective. A catalyst action is selective. That means when you change a catalyst in a reaction, the products formed also changes. When you change a catalyst in a reaction, the product formed also changes. See different examples. First one, carbon monoxide plus hydrogen. Their combination may give methane, methanol and methanol. CO plus H2 CO plus H2 combination may give, using nickel as catalyst, it gives methane plus CO, CO plus H2 na, methane plus H2O. When nickel is the catalyst, the products are methane plus water. When copper is the catalyst, HCHO, what is this? Methanol or formaldehyde is the product. When we use a mixture of zinc oxide plus chromium oxide, then the product is methanol, that means methyl alcohol. See this reaction? Reactants are same. We are changing the catalyst. When you change the catalyst in a reaction, there is change in the products. Have a look on this example. See, in the with first catalyst, with nickel, methane is the product. With copper, formaldehyde. With the mixture of these two, zinc oxide and chromium trioxide, zinc oxide and chromium oxide, CH3OH is the product. See one more example for this. One more example. Ethyl alcohol, CH3CH2OH. Ethyl alcohol, when it is subjected to first one dehydration, it will give ethylene, CH2 double bond CH2, it is called what? Ethylene, where water is eliminated. Elimination of water in a reaction is called what? Dehydration. It is dehydration occurs in the presence of a catalyst Al2O3. So here around 350 degree centigrade temperature is required. Next, with using the catalyst copper or silver, around 300 degree centigrade temperature, it undergoes dehydrogenation to give, what is this? Ethanol. Ethanol. All. All means aldehyde. So here, what is the other product? H2. Elimination of H2 is called what? Dehydrogenation. The first one is dehydration, the second one is dehydrogenation. Okay? See, when you change the catalyst, there is change in the products. The first product is ethylene, the second product is ethanol. Okay? So, the catalyst action is selective. This is these are examples for this point, a catalyst action is selective. Next, you know, some substances along with catalyst when added, they increase the activity of catalyst. Such substances which increase the activity of a catalyst are called promoters. What are those substances? Promoters. So, a substance which increases the activity of a catalyst is called promoter. Promoter. Have a look on examples. Promoter just increases the activity of catalyst. It supports the catalyst. If promoter itself is added, it doesn't work. If promoter itself is added, if it works, it is now called as catalyst. Na? So promoter itself doesn't work. But when it is added along with catalyst, it increases the activity of a catalyst only. When the activity of catalyst increases, it increases the rate of reaction further. See examples. So in this reaction, what is in Haber's method for the preparation of ammonia, what is the reaction? See, N2 gas plus 3H2 gas gives rise to 2NH3 gas. This is the reaction in Haber's method. Haber's method for the synthesis of ammonia. In this reaction, what is catalyst used? Catalyst used is iron, and in this promoter is molybdenum or Al2O3 or potassium oxide. Any of these three can be added to the reaction, which increases the rate of, which increases the activity of catalyst. So promoter just supports the catalyst. Promoter, without catalyst, if promoter only added a reaction, it does not increase the rate of reaction, it does not affect the reaction. The only purpose of promoter is to increase the activity of catalyst. Okay, next, see the next property. What is catalyst poison? So for that, let's see a point. Just like a substance increasing the activity, there are some other substances which decrease the activity of a catalyst. So such a substance which decreases, the activity of a catalyst, a substance which decreases the activity of a catalyst is called catalytic poison. What is that? Catalytic poison. Promoter increases the activity, whereas poison decreases the activity. See some examples in which catalytic poisons are present. For the reaction N2 gas plus 3H2 gas to give 2NH3 gas. This is a Haber's method for the synthesis of ammonia, where catalyst used is, what is that? Iron. You know, in this, what is the poison? Either H2S or CO. Hydrogen sulfide or carbon monoxide, if present in the reaction, that reaction will be slowed down. Why? The compound H2S or CO decreases the activity of catalyst iron. This is first example. See another example for it. In the contact process for the preparation of sulfuric acid, first we prepare sulfur dioxide. See the reaction. What is the contact process reaction? 2SO2 gas plus O2 gas gives rise to platinum. Here 2SO3 gas. So in this reaction, catalyst is platinum, whereas poison, what is poison? Poison is arsenic trioxide, As2O3. So in this contact process for the manufacturing of sulfuric acid, this arsenic trioxide As2O3 acts as catalytic poison for the catalyst platinum. Similarly, one more example. In the preparation of water from H2 and O2, in this reaction, platinum is the catalyst. Platinum is the catalyst. Here product is water. So what is catalyst here? Here catalyst is platinum. Poison is CO. CO acts as poison. So these are some examples where catalytic poisons are added. Okay, so these are all characteristic properties of Catalysis.